The Great Illusion was written in 1910 by Norman Angell. War between advanced nations make no sense in an age of economic integration. With its growing population, Germany wanted what Britain had and began a large military buildup to achieve it, sowing the seeds for the First World War. The author wrote, "An economic integration had increased between states to such an extent that it would be in no interest to go to the war in this new age. Large-scale conflict was the greatest folly." Only 5 years later, Germany invaded Belgium and the bloodbath claimed 16 million people. 20 years later, it would happen again at a cost of 50 million lives. Clearly, the author and many smart people like him had been deluded. Economic integration may have helped to keep Europe at peace, but it was clearly no barrier against the human irrationality that is fear, greed, pride. That was the usual cause of war. It had always been thus and always would be. The build-up of Germany's naval power was an expression of its growing population and wish to gain Britain's colonies and trading wealth through conquest. Put more simply, this is the idea that the national prosperity rests on political power. Yes, nations may compete peacefully to win business or trade, but in the stiff competition between them, the country that is best backed by military force will win the day. In the Darwinian geopolitical struggle, weaker nations will also be the poorer nations. It is only weak states that will wage offensive war, perhaps to buttress the regime's power and disguise inherent domestic disunity and weakness. The author is far-sighted in noting that the real conflict in the modern worlds are between different ways of seeing the world. Democratic versus autocratic, socialism versus individualism, reaction versus progress. It was a prophetic thought, as only a couple of months later, Putin Russian army seized Crimea in sovereign Ukraine in land grab reminiscence of Hitler or Stalin. Yet the author admitted he had too much faith that economic independence would prevent war. But he stood by his argument that conflict paid no dividends.